drama post is a satire on social values degradation. The title of our drama is The Dear Departed. It is written by Stanley Houghton. Let us discuss about the characters who all are there in the play. Abel Merriweather would be the grandfather. Emilia's sister, Slater, is the elder daughter. Henry Slater is son-in-law. Victoria is granddaughter. Fine, the next family is Jordans. Elizabeth is the younger daughter. Ben is son-in-law. And Jimmy Jordan is grandson. Here, the grandfather's role is Abel Merriweather. He is an old person of 72. Amelia Slater, Henry Slater, and Victoria Slater. These three are from Slater families. Grandfather is right now staying with Slater families. Before 3 years, he was staying with Jordans. For 5 years, he stayed there with them. But now the current situation is that grandfather is living with Slaters. Let us discuss something about its theme. The play is a satire on social and moral values degradation. Why the moral values, social values are degrading day by day? Is there any reason? There are n number of old age homes where old age people are lying helpless there. Though they are being taken care by some organizations, but the family members are totally neglecting them. What are the reasons why they are neglected? Here, few reasons I have made out. Lack of human values. Nowadays, materialistic education is provided. No moral-based education is provided. Student is in the competitive world. He wants to come first in every race. But lack of time doesn't let that child study with the experiences, with the old people. Considered liability. Reasons of old people, they are considered to be liabilities because they are physically very weak. They are not capable of doing work, the regular work. They need assistance. They provided help to their children. But now children are not able to help them. They take their parents as liabilities. Lack of patience. Yes. Lack of patience is the biggest thing because of which the old age homes are increasing day by day. People are not having patience to listen to them. And what else is there? Nowadays, youngsters do not have time. And whatever time they have, they want to spend that time on their own. With themselves or with their friends, not with the family. That is why they do not have patience and they get burst out when they are interrupted and when they are demanded something by their parents. Increasing materialism. Yes, this is one of the major factor which is creating great negligence. Increasing materialism means everybody is interested in having the material, but not the values. Everybody is after property. Everybody wants to own something which belonged to their ancestors, but do not want them to be with them. Lack of time, of course. Lack of time. They do not have time. They are running after money. They are running after their career. They are running after everything. But they are leaving their family aside. Don't want to hold their responsibility. True. Nowadays, they are so much occupied with their pre-plans and the other things that they do not want to have any responsibility on their shoulders. These are the major reasons why these old age people are facing negligence, which is not right. Well, this was the certain theme of the drama. These are all the characters. Though this drama is a satire on social values, but it is presented in a funny way. You'll get to know the theme of the drama at the end. Okay, a drama starts with Slater. So the first plot is here with Slaters. Amelia Slater, Henry Slater, Victoria Slater. These three are Slaters. Right now, grandfather, the common person, lives with Slaters nowadays. So what happens? Meriwether is lying dead in his room upstairs in the house. The setup is of a house in a narrow lane where upstairs grandfather is lying dead. Amelia called her daughter Victoria from outside, who was playing in colorful dress. She called out for her daughter and asked her to change into mourning dress as her grandfather is no more. On the next hand, Amelia sends Henry to purchase something which she can offer to her sister and brother-in-law. They will be coming shortly because they are informed that grandfather is no more. This is the story. So they all are after money. Victoria is a mature girl. She is of 10 years. While Jimmy's age is not defined. It's not given in any of the chapter. So we'll also consider Jimmy's age as 8 years. Approximately. Okay, Slaters are the elder ones and Jordans are the younger ones. So right now, what happened? When the grandfather dies, Slaters inform Jordans that grandfather is no more, and they both have called them to their place so that they can see grandfather for the last time and do the needful. Here, Slaters and Jordans, they both are very greedy. They want to own all the property possessed by the grandfather. Amelia and Elizabeth, they are more into materialism and their husbands are supportive. Henry is a bit timid kind of personality. He listens to his wife's instructions, while Ben Jordan is not like that. Okay, so Ben Jordan is more cunning. How he's more cunning? Like Elizabeth is a bit stricter, while Ben Jordan is the person who chuckles a lot, who makes fun of everything. Okay, so the grandfather is dead, no one is there, and then what happens? Victoria is asked to change because her aunt and uncle would be coming there soon. Now what happens? Amelia asked Henry that she wants to have the bureau. Bureau is a multi-drawer table which she wanted to have from grandfather's room. She asked Henry for the same. She asked Henry that she wanted to have grandfather's bureau into her room. So she wanted to have that before Elizabeth comes. Henry asked her to settle down all the things, all the belongings with Elizabeth only. But Amelia here disagrees. She said, if Elizabeth would be knowing this, that I want this bureau, the bargain would be going much costlier. So Elizabeth is not at all aware about that bureau. That is why she wanted to have that bureau. And she would be replacing that bureau with her old chest. Chest is again the drawer kind of almirah, which is very old. So now what happened? They are shifting that bureau from grandfather's room to theirs. They did not notice grandfather. In fact, they noticed that bureau. They brought their bureau now and instructed Victoria strictly that not to open door if they come or not. Without permission, she was not supposed to open the door. The knocking on the door was continuously going on, but they were shifting the bureau. That is why they did not open the door. Later on, what happens? When Jordans came before their arrival, Amelia made Henry sit near the fireplace and handed him a magazine so that it may look realistic that they were in the morning and Henry was sitting silently at one place. She did one more thing. She pinched the clock which was in grandfather's room. She pinched that bureau, she pinched the clock, and now one more thing she did, which was very cheap, very, very cheap. She pinched grandfather's brand new slippers and gave it to Henry, because Henry's slippers were going quite old. So the straps of the slipper were coming off. That is why she gave the new brand slippers of grandfather's to Henry. When Henry said it is not getting fit in, then she said, wear it, it will get spread. But you need to wear it. We have to utilize. She pretends as if she's sad. She pretends as if she'll see any of the scattering of grandfather's belonging, she would be feeling sad, and made Henry wear those slippers. Victoria is observing each and everything. She even asked her father that, are we pinching grandfather's thing? Then Henry tries to convince Victoria that, Victoria, your grandfather only asked your mother to take that bureau after his death. That is why she is taking that bureau. Then she was quiet. After that, what happened? The doorbell rang and Jordan's came. Slater was ready with the black gown, which is the mourning dress in Christianity, and Elizabeth was also there. Elizabeth reached over there. She was in the black mourning dress, and Jordan was also there. But they did not bring Jimmy along with them. Just these two people came over there. They welcomed both of them and made them sit on the dining table. She asked Jordans whether if they want to have tea first or want to see grandfather's dead body. They preferred to have tea first. They said, now he is no more, what will be seeing in him? So it would be better if they will be served with the tea. While having tea, Amelia opens the package of pie, apple pie, and presents in front of them to show off. Both the sisters believe in show off. They both are very greedy. They want to have everything and they believe in show off. So then what happens? While taking tea, they were discussing about newspaper. They both said, we need to declare grandfather's death through newspaper to the people. So that how it has to be done. So that each and every person can get to know that he is no more. Then again the conflict goes on between Jordans and Slaters. Slater said a few lines are there which he read in an old newspaper a few days back. So can those lines be there? Then Elizabeth said, no, poetic lines should be there, and that too very big. It doesn't matter with the amount or the money would be charged. It's completely fine, but it has to go with the newspaper only. So this conflict was going on between them. After that, what happened? Suddenly Ben observes the bureau. His attention went towards the bureau. He asked, it's an antique bureau. From where did you got? Then suddenly, Amelia said, Henry got it from an auction. Like this, they were discussing the things and they were least interested in talking about grandfather's health. Then later on, the second topic went on, like, was grandfather shown to any doctor? They refused. Mrs. Slater said that he needed that while he was alive, Dr. Pringle was taking care of his health. But now when Dr. Pringle is not there in the city, he is out of town. So that is why they did not call anybody else. It's the health ethics that if some specific doctor is taking care of any specific person, he or she is supposed to watched by that doctor only. That is why they did not call any other doctor. Here, not out of concern, they are discussing all these things, but they wanted to make sure that grandfather is really dead or not. Then the discussion went on, and they came to the conclusion that grandfather is now no more. It has nothing to do with the doctor's calling or no. He has been declared dead by them because since morning he is lying on the floor cold. After that, what happens? They were discussing about the distribution of the items. They wanted to make a list and then want to distribute the things. Meanwhile, what happens? Elizabeth said to Amelia that father has a golden watch which he promised Jimmy, that he would be giving that golden watch to Jimmy because he loved Jimmy very much. This was the reason. And suddenly, Amelia protested. No, when did he do that? He didn't do that. In fact, he left Victoria also, but he didn't do any such thing to Victoria. I cannot believe. Later on, the division of things were conflicting. They were in a great conflict and they were not able to share the things. And suddenly what happened? They wanted to have a premium slip. Grandfather was having a premium, insurance premium. He was submitting the premium. They were discussing about death. The last in the morning, grandfather went to LIC insurance company and submit the premium. They wanted to see the receipt. That's why they sent Victoria upstairs, where Victoria notices that grandfather was moving. Victoria was very much shocked and she was afraid, and that's why she came running towards the people, the other family members, and there she said, grandfather is moving. Everybody calls Victoria mad because they knew grandfather is no more and a dead person cannot move. And suddenly, after a few minutes, grandfather, Abel Merryweather, came down with a gown, with a funny gown. He came down and saw all the family members in mourning dress, and he was shocked. He was looking for his slippers all around, but he didn't find. He was asking, Amelia, where are my slippers? Then suddenly what she did, she snatched the slippers from Henry and handed it to grandfather. Grandfather was amazed that what my slippers are doing there. Then later on what happened, he suddenly saw that bureau. He said, how my bureau came over here? He was shocked. The moment he talked about bureau, the clock, the pinched clock, strike the time. And again, grandfather was shocked. My clock also is there. So he said, is there any ghost in our house who's taking away my things and getting my things down? He was at utter shock. Then the truth was revealed that both the sisters have gathered over there just because grandfather was no more. Last time, Jordans had a fighting with Slaters, and Elizabeth swear that she would never enter into Slater's house next time. But this time she entered to get her share. She was very cunning, she was very greedy. To take her share out of grandfather's belonging, she came over there. Grandfather was quite happy to see all the family together, but he was upset also because he saw everybody in mourning dress. Then later on, he got to know from sister's fight only that they presumed grandfather to be dead while he was alive. Now grandfather was very upset and he decided that he is leaving the house very next day and he will take all his belonging to some other place, wherever he'll be living. He declared that whatever he belonged, whatever he owned, whatever he possessed would be given to the person who would be staying with grandfather, who will be taking care of grandfather. Now sisters again fight. Mrs. Slater said, I want to keep grandfather. It's just 3 years. You have kept grandfather for 5 years. Elizabeth said, you have not done a fair thing with father. That is why you won't be keeping father. I'll be taking care of him. So like this fight goes on, and then Abel Merryweather declares that I would be staying with Ringo Bill's owner, a widow. He would be staying with a widow who runs a Ringo Bill's, a drink house, a cafeteria kind of place. So he decided to spend his rest of life with that widow, taking his all belongings there only. And this is the end of the drama where it ended. In this drama, what we observed, these two sisters are fighting for materialism. They were not upset because their father died. They were upset because their father was alive and they were not able to get their shares. This sister, Amelia's sister, she pinched many things from grandfather. Henry supported. Victoria was upset. She was mature and she was able to catch everything. She was feeling very upset about grandfather's death. Elizabeth Jordan started talking about his golden watch. She did not go to visit grandfather once when he died. Ben Jordan was the supporter of Mrs. Jordan. Jimmy Jordan is a small boy. of Jordans. So all these things are there. Here the title itself shows the irony. What is the irony of the chapter? The dear departed. Depart means to separate. Dear means the one whom we love the most. Whom we admire, whom we love, with whom we are connected. So that is why the dear departed title is given. But here, dear is grandfather, departed was grandfather actually dear to anyone? No, he was not dear to anyone. He departed when he separated, like when he was declared dead, then everybody was happy. While the title says when somebody dear departs, it makes us sad, it makes us gloomy. But here the dear, so-called dear, departed, then what happened? They were happy that after his death, everything he possessed will be ours. So this is the drama which is done over here. Thank you. Since we are done with the explanation of the drama, the dear departed, let us move to some important questions which are generally considered to be most important for your examination. So first question is, bring out the irony in the title of the whole play. The irony we have earlier also discussed. While starting the chapter, we discussed that the title itself says the dear departed. Dear means the one whom we love. Departed means separated. In this drama, the dear is called for grandfather. The dear word is used for grandfather. But here, grandfather was actually not dear because his departure, his separation from the family did not upset anyone. In fact, they were discussing about the division of material, belongings, possess, whatever the grandfather possessed. They were discussing about those things in spite, rather than discussing about grandfather's death. So this is the irony in the title. Are we pitching it before Aunt Elizabeth comes? What does it refer? This is the sentence said by Victoria when Slaters were shifting bureau from upstairs to downstairs, replacing it with the chest, old chest. That time Elizabeth asks that, are we stealing this bureau before Aunt Elizabeth comes? What does it refer to here? It refers to the bureau. Okay, what was being pinched? It was bureau. How Vicky here is Victoria. How Vicky concluded that her parents are pinching because grandfather was no more. She was asked not to open the door till they come down and ask her to open the door. So with these two incidents, she concluded that they were pinching because it was pinching is generally done in the hidden, and they were hiding this shifting from Jordans. That is why she concluded that her parents were pinching the bureau. I don't call that delicate. Stepping into dead man's shoe in such a haste. This was said by Elizabeth because as it was there in the drama, Amelia made Henry wear his father's new slippers. Yes, in that context, Elizabeth said this. When grandfather came down and he was looking for his slippers to wear, suddenly Mrs. Amelia Slater snatched those slippers and gave it to grandfather. Elizabeth said that it was not a decent job. It wasn't good enough. It was not good to grab somebody who is dead thing. Okay, as she got to know that Henry was wearing grandfather's slippers. That is why she called that thing ingenious. Bring out the significance of this statement. The significance we have already discussed. The next question is, what prompts the speaker to say here? She was also very greedy. She also wanted to have the things. When she got to know that they have pinched sleepers too, she was annoyed. That is why this greed prompted her to speak this statement. What change did grandfather make in his new will? What was its impact? Grandfather changed his will. Earlier, it was there that he would be dividing the things into two equal halves. Why? After seeing all these things, when he saw his daughters fighting for his property, then he decided to change his will. Now he decided that he would be handovering or giving his property to the person with whom he was staying. This change was, and he decided that on the coming Monday, because that day was the Sunday, the next day he would be leaving the house and going to widow's house. The widow was running the Ringo Bell's juice store. Okay, the last question. It seems to me that neither of you has any cause to feel proud about the way you have treated me, justified. The statement is said by grandfather. Grandfather said this statement because he feels that he died and both the sisters are fighting for the material, fighting for the belongings of grandfather. They wanted to have that. As Amelia already shifted his bureau, his clock, his slippers, and Elizabeth wanted to have that golden watch and many other things. So this fight made him realize that no one is proud to have him with them. That is why he wanted to leave. Thus, the statement gets over. Thank you.